Take six, marker.
Whales sequester 33 tons of carbon in their lifetimes, so part of what would help in fighting climate change is effective whale preservation. We gathered a team of 7 internationally renowned marine experts, and unanimously they said that they needed rigorous marine tag-derived data. So we made MOBY, which is a non-invasive data tag. Whale tracking data tags only last between 6 and 24 hours. That's not enough time to get the kind of data that would really be effective.
Our project can be simplified into 4 main modules.
We have an energy regeneration system so that the tag can do its data collection for longer,
which was the turbine in the back. There's also an onboard sensor pack, which is depth, humidity, temperature, and orientation.
We have a 5K video feed that self-aligns to always point forward.
And we did that by testing different geometries in the wind tunnel, and then our remora suction.
If you've ever been to the aquarium and you see suckerfish sticking to the side, that's a remora. They're also really good at sticking to the sides of whales and sharks. Just by switching, we estimate that this tag lifetime is closer to a week. And of course, we have the speed sensor. The researchers were thrilled. Every time we emailed them, they were saying, like, speed sensor with 10 exclamation points. If you can increase the span of how long your data tag is lasting, you can see a lot more of what underwater life looks like.
Take 10, marker.
New York City has a large water supply wastage issue. We do lose around 16 to 24% of it every year. Over 40% of our pipes are more than 80 years old, and we have over 400 water main breaks every year.
There are devices on the market that are for finding where there are cracks and leaks, but the problem is that those require the pipes usually to be trenched and dug out, which is where we came up with the idea of entering through a fire hydrant.
Once we realized that we could get in through fire hydrants, it felt like an epiphany moment for us, a eureka moment.
There would be 2 main data collection mechanisms. One of them is a camera that's in this waterproof chamber. You can see we've got this little window here, and also an inertial measurement unit, and that could show us where the thimble is as it's traveling onward.
There's a main propeller and motor in the front here that pushes water into these side channels controlled by butterfly valves. So that allows us to both move forward and turn.
All right.
And of course, since we're getting video outputs, it could be applied to something like a machine learning algorithm to automatically identify a leak or corrosion or cracks.
We wanted to give New York City a better idea of the piping situations underground. Afterwards, we realized, oh, we're building a submarine.
Pick one.
Housing is not just about buildings, it's about wastewater and it's about recreational space. And so in designing infrastructure, you can't just design a building, you need to think about those other components.
So we were driven by the concept of engineering for humanity, so basically design a project that benefits the community.
The challenge is that there was a historic train station building that was moved to this site in the middle of town. There is a lack of recreational space as well as housing in this area. The reason that more housing can't be built in this town is because there is no centralized wastewater treatment. It's currently just a big empty lot.
A living machine is basically just a wastewater management technology that uses plants to create an environment for microbiomes to grow and digest the waste.
And the idea is that this water could then be reused throughout the system while also providing a really essential part of infrastructure for the area. And this also is then brought into our constructed wetland.
So not only can you visit the wastewater treatment plant, but you can also kind of walk through the wetland. So we wanted stylistic continuity in this town center and make it a place that people really want to gather in.
Take 14, Mark.
ParkinPlay offers affordable and accessible monitoring of Parkinson's symptoms outside the clinic. Oftentimes when Parkinson's patients are either diagnosed with Parkinson's or want to just monitor their symptoms, they have to go and visit a neurologist. What we realize is that there is a need for more frequent monitoring that's more objective and comprehensive of disease progression. So ParkinPlay is a combination of an app and a wearable sensor.
When the user is brought to the homepage, you'll see that we have logging. So what logging allows the user to do is log their medications, their moods, and their sleep.
Another feature that our app offers is the ability to monitor symptoms relative to medication dosages. Now, it's just trial and error. You take a medication dosage, you think about how you're feeling, and then you go to your doctor and tell them.
The second section of our app is activities based on talks with professors, including Dr. Pullman, who's well known for his spiral trace analysis, as well as finger tapping. Those two activities complement our gait sensor.
And so we wanted to create a sensor that would be able to measure these movements in an objective way.
We really focused on tremor and bradykinesia and gait because these are things that can truly be improved. something that I think Engineering for Humanity, I think we learned throughout our experience, is that we should be designing products that really help people, and people should be the center of our designs.